Good afternoon. Today is the 6th of July and it's a big day on the channel because I have here the 2020 MGZS 1.5 exclusive manual. I'm here at Summit Garage in Dudley and they very kindly let me film this. There will be a full review of this car on the channel coming up in the next week or so. We'll be filming that tomorrow, but I've got here a day early because I know that lots of you love new MG content and this is about as new as it gets. This car was only put on the MG Motor UK website last week. The pre-facelift model, which looks like this, that's a laser blue colour. This is Battersea Blue. Has been improved in many ways. First of all, I'll show you straight away. If I unlock the car, we've now got power folding mirrors. They were previously exclusive to the MGZS EV. We've got chrome strips on this exclusive model. They were previously exclusive to the ZS EV. We've got different wheel designs, 17-inch wheels, but with a taller profile tyre because many people said that the wheels actually look a little bit too small for the car. These are Michelin tyres on this particular one. It is a different wheel design, as I said. And they are, if I can read that properly, 55 profile tyres. 215 55 R17. The headlamps on this car, I believe, are now full LED. I'm not going to quote that because the information I've got at the moment is a bit scarce. So I think these are full LED headlamps on this car now. Looks absolutely wonderful in this colour. You can see there the previous colour, laser blue, is a little bit different from this. Many features taken out of the HS, which I drove back in December. You can find that video on the channel, the Walkaround, a full review, were implemented on this facelifted model. I think we've even got blind spot detection on this particular car, because if you look by the side, those are surround view cameras. You can get surround view on this particular car, which is crazy. Now, the list price of this particular car is about $18,300 or so. The base model starts the Excite at $15,000. I apologise for the light. It's just nothing I can do about that, really. There we go. The Excite now starts at $15,500. The automatic version of this car with a 1-litre engine, like the one in the background there, that's not coming, I believe, until next year. Let's open this up. I think the door should open. Yep. There we go. I haven't got keyless entry in this, which I don't like anyway, so that's absolutely fine. If you look at this interior, hopefully it won't get the light coming in like that so much. I'll just be a little bit careful. There we go. Yes, 18,340. Got an electric seat adjustment on this car now. Got a different steering wheel with the red stitching. In fact, you'll find red stitching all over this car. Same controls for the fuel release and the bonnet release, which I find a little bit confusing. Still got hard touch plastics on the door tops, but we do have this red leather stitching. Reminds me of the HS and also the pre-facelift MG3. And of course, I used to own a pre-facelift MG3, for over 3 years, so I'm very familiar with those. Same manual 5-speed gearbox as before in the 1.5 version. As you can see, there is now a 360-degree camera, which is down there. We'll see if we can demonstrate that in a sec. Rather than one USB port in the front, we now have two. We've also got, behind the conventional handbrake, thank goodness for one of those, we've got a conventional sort of armrest as well, which the pre-facelift cars didn't have, not even the top model. I do like this red stitching and the MG logo. Right, let's get in the back. Same nice wide opening doors as before, and still not got a rear armrest. That's a bit of a shame. I was expecting them to have changed that. But what they have put in is two rear USB ports. Before, there were none on the pre-face, none at all. So if I just climb in here, it's just me filming today. So I'm afraid you're gonna have to bear with me. Whoa, still absolutely loads of legroom. Still absolutely loads of headroom. No panoramic sunroof, that's probably exclusive still to the MG ZS EV. Very comfortable though. I don't know if this is faux or real leather. On the pre-facelift cars, it's faux leather, so I've no reason to doubt that that is anything different. Still hard plastics on the door, but to be honest, if you're buying a car like this, sort of Nissan Juke, let's go to Kamiq, Volkswagen T-Cross class, very often they do have hard plastics. Rear electric windows, of course, more of this nice stitching and material, and big pockets in the back. I think it's time to look in the boot. Right. Up the MG badge, and yep, still got the movable height boot floor. I will put the key in my pocket. I can demonstrate that. Apologies for the background noise. This garage is on the main road. There we go. Yes, boot is now in its high position. Boot capacity remains the same as before, 448 litres, just as it was in the pre-facelift petrol models and in the ZS EV. Nice and useful. Deep little wells either side. Just put that boot down to the lower position so you can just get an idea of how much luggage space there is. There we go, that's what I'd normally have if I would have this car. If we look underneath the floor, it's probably got just a tyre repair kit. Yes, it has. Although you probably could fit a spare wheel in there if you wanted to do so. Nice sturdy parcel shelf. And just quite a nice, well-built car for the price, really. Right, let's go and look at the engine. So this is the same 1.5-litre four-cylinder engine as the pre-facelift manual cars. Absolutely masses of space to work on here. Generates 105 brake horsepower, 0-60 about 11 seconds. The WLTP economy figures for this car are somewhere in the region of 41 miles per gallon on average. With the MG3 we used to get, it was a little bit more than that. It was, I think, about 42, 43. Your mileage may vary. The 1 litre automatic, which is a pre-facelift, looks like that. That's not coming, as I said, probably this year, probably a little bit later. Obviously, with everything that's been going on in the world, the launch of the automatic has been delayed a little bit. And anyway, when this car first came out in 2017, the automatic was maybe 6 months behind, so that's not unusual. No turbo or anything on this, nothing fancy, but very easy to work on. Of course, you get a 7-year warranty on all new MGs. Fantastic. Okay, I'm now in. And I've adjusted the seat so I can sit comfortably in here. Just put that down so we don't get too much reflection from the sun. Huge, big central touchscreen now. But one thing I would say is that the air conditioning controls have been moved from this kind of area here along these piano keys, and I don't think that's a particularly positive change. It's not really my favourite. We have got hill descent control, which is amazing. Button for turning the traction control off. The 360 camera, let's see what happens if I press that button there. There we go, there is the 360 degree camera and my reflection. So reversing camera and a 360 degree camera. That might be pretty useful actually tomorrow when we film a full review when we're pulling out of here. That might be good. Just turn that off, and then the button for turning the stop start system on and off. So I'll see if I can get a little bit away from this so you don't see so much reflection. If we go setup, see what things we've got in here. We've got all sorts of things. Bluetooth, a 10.1 inch screen as opposed to the, I think the 8 inch screen from the pre-facelift cars. really apologise for the sunlight coming in. There's not an awful lot I can do about it, and hold the camera down a bit. I go back to the main menu, which is the home button there. Go to car, see if we've got driving assistance. We've got, wow, rear driving assist, blind spot detection, lane change assist, rear cross traffic alert, all sorts of things. We've got lighting, follow me home lights and find my car, lights and horn, what other is. Ooh, the steering wheel button settings for smartphones, fantastic. I do believe this car does now come with Android Auto as well as Apple CarPlay, which is wonderful. So we've got the steering, you can change that from urban, which is the lightest, dynamic, heaviest, and normal is the one in the middle. If you go back to the main menu, you can see here we've got Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, although neither is highlighted because they're not connected at the moment. Just turn that temperature down a bit. Coldest setting, yeah, right down to the bottom, thank you. See, if you do operate these temperature controls, and say you have the navigation on, and you wait for the navigation to load, come along. Right, that's now loaded. So, sorry about the light there again. Takes a while. Yeah, accept. There we go. So if I was having the navigation on and I needed to know where I was going, if I just press this fan speed button there, and it says wind level, not some fan speed, that's interesting. Hopefully it won't be the level of my wind. Then that is a bit of a shame. Same sort of glove box as before. We'll test that size with the secret mission documents tomorrow. It's now got much nicer soft touch plastic material on here. Very nice. Automatic lights and wipers in this car, of course. And these kind of nice turbine style air vents. I think it's just standard air conditioning here rather than climate control, but that's no different. That's what it was like on the pre-faced models too. Still soft touch materials on top of the dashboard as well. Nice big door pockets down there for my sunglasses. Four electric windows, and there are the door locking buttons. Massive, massive, big digital screen here. And if we just go down, I think, there we go. We can see all the information we need. Tire pressure monitoring as well. Changes the voltage of the battery. There's just seeing if my lights are on and the doors are open and things like that. So digital dials in this car. I imagine there's probably a setting for changing the appearance of these dials. I can't find that at the moment. Unfortunately, I don't have too much information on this car because it's so new. But maybe in the full review we'll be looking at that a bit extra. But I do like it in here. But this car is quite comfortable. There is no telescopic adjustment for the steering. It's just for the rake angle. High speed manual gearbox, that feels very nice. And there are a couple of cup holders down there. Excellent. So there we are, the 2020 MG ZS 1.5 exclusive manual. This particular car, because of the Battersea Blue colour, will retail for about £18,340. The range starts at £15,500 for the Excite model. The Explore's been dropped now due to low sales. Can't blame them really, because that didn't really sell very many with no air conditioning. Just to show you the SAAC light technology there, which I imagine is full LED headlamps in this car, and perhaps even adapter ones, I'm not actually sure, as I don't have a spec sheet for it. This exclusive model will start at about £17,800, and with this colour it's £18,340. So I hope you found this video to be useful. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel for the full review, which will be coming probably next week. Don't forget to like this video and to leave a comment below. Thank you once again to Summit Garage for allowing me to film this car today. I'm probably one of the first people to do a walk around at the moment, I'm honest, even though it's not a very good one and my light keeps going and it's really annoying. But yes, don't forget to visit me on Facebook, facebook.com/LloydVeerConsulting, and also my website, www.lloydvehicleconsulting.co.uk. I do apologise for all the background noise and general incompetence and bad lighting and everything. But thank you ever so much indeed once again for watching.